Blackstone Audio presents Progress, 10 Reasons to Look Forward to the Future, by Johan Norberg. This book is read by Derek Perkins. To Alicia, Alexander, and Nils Erik, it's your world now. The progress of human knowledge will be rapid, and discoveries made of which we have at present no conception. I begin to be almost sorry I was born so soon, since I cannot have the happiness of knowing what will be known 100 years hence. Benjamin Franklin, 1783. Introduction. The good old days are now. Nothing is more responsible for the good old days than a bad memory. Franklin Pierce Adams. Terrorism. ISIS. War in Syria and Ukraine, crime, murder, mass shootings, famines, floods, pandemics, global warming, stagnation, poverty, refugees. Doom and gloom everywhere, as a woman on the street responded when public radio asked her to describe the state of the world. This is what we see in the news, and it seems to be the story of our time. An article about the zeitgeist ahead of New Year's Eve 2015 in the Financial Times ran with the headline, "Battered, bruised and jumpy. The whole world is on edge." These perceptions feed the fear and nostalgia on which Donald Trump has built his US presidential campaign. 58% of those who voted for Britain to leave the EU in the country's recent referendum say life is worse today than 30 years ago. In 1955, 13% of the Swedish public thought that there were intolerable conditions in society. After half a century of expanded human liberties, rising incomes, reduction in poverty, and improved healthcare, more than half of all Swedes thought so. Many experts and authorities agree. General Martin Dempsey, chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, recently testified before US Congress, "I will personally attest to the fact that the world is more dangerous than it has ever been." Pope Francis claims that globalization has condemned many people to starve. It is true that in absolute terms the world's wealth has grown, but inequality and poverty have arisen. On the political left, activist Naomi Klein argues our civilization is on a collision course and that we are destabilizing our planet's life support system. On the right, philosopher John Gray thinks that human beings are Homo rapiens, a predatory and destructive species that is approaching the end of civilization. I used to share their pessimism. When I began to shape my worldview in Sweden in the 1980s, I found modern civilization hard to stomach. Factories, highways, and supermarkets, to me, were a dismal sight, and modern working life seemed sheer drudgery. I associated this new global consumer culture with the problems of poverty and conflict that television brought into our living room. Instead, I dreamed of a society that put the clock back, a society that lived in harmony with nature. I hadn't thought about the way people had actually lived before the Industrial Revolution, without medicines and antibiotics, safe water, sufficient food, electricity, or sanitary systems. Instead, I had thought of it more in terms of a modern excursion into the countryside. As part of my studies, I started reading history and traveling the world. I found I could no longer romanticize the good old days once I began to understand what they had really been like. One of the countries on which I focused my studies experienced chronic undernourishment. It was poorer, with shorter life expectancy and higher child mortality, than the average sub-Saharan African country. That country was my ancestors' Sweden 150 years ago. The truth is that if we care to turn the clock back, the good old days were awful. Despite what we hear on the news and from many authorities, the great story of our era is that we are witnessing the greatest improvement in global living standards ever.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.